We are here with Marion Nestle, professor at the New York University. Mrs. Nestle, thank you for joining this conversation promoted by Barilla Center for Food and Nutrition. We all know that nutrition has a very strong impact not only on our health, but also on the environment and the economics. Do you think that policymakers are really aware of that?
Absolutely not. They haven't got a clue. Everything is put in compartments, so that nutrition is in one place, climate is another, the environment is another, agriculture is in another. And that's why it doesn't work. That's why the problems don't get solved, because unless all of those groups work together, they're not going to make any progress at all.
Alimentary styles are not easy to change, especially among younger people, and it requires a lot of time. Which are, in your opinion, the most effective tools?
To change people's dietary habits?
Yes.
If you want to change people's dietary habits, you have to change the food that they're given. People don't choose food in a vacuum. They choose from the foods that are available, what they're given, what they buy themselves, what's available at the store, what's culturally appropriate for the environment that they live in. If you want to change the way people eat, you have to change their eating environment.
Especially for younger people.
Especially for younger people who are so influenced by food marketing. So they think that the foods that are advertised and marketed are the ones that they're supposed to be eating. But if that's not what they're eating at home, if it's not what they're given when they go out, they'll eat in different ways. It's very easy to change people's diets. All you have to do is give them different food and give them a little time to get adapted to it, and they'll do just fine.
Scientific research goes on discovering the effects of different diets on our health, often with controversial results, as typically happens with scientific progress. Where are we now, and what is important to know for policymakers and companies?
Well, I think the issue of diet is very simple. Humans have existed for hundreds of thousands of years, eating whatever was available. There is no one diet. For health, you can take whatever the foods are that are available and put them together in extremely healthful ways. And I think dietary advice is very simple. If you're worried about overweight, you eat less, you move more, eat plenty of fruits, vegetables, and grains, don't eat too much junk food, and enjoy what you're eating. It's as simple as that. Where it gets complicated is the science which focuses on single nutrients rather than foods, and the marketing issues, which predominate in Western societies.
The competition between different diets is also a competition between different geographic areas, Northern Europe, Mediterranean, Asia. Who is going to win and who is going to lose?
We have a global food supply now. I mean, I don't think it's a question of winning and losing. It's a question of what's available globally, because if you're importing foods from all over the world, you're going to be eating those foods. If you're selling your foods all over the world, you're going to be eating those foods. I don't think it's a question of winning or losing. I think it's a question of people eating foods that they like from where they are. As there's more and more pressure to grow foods locally and not to have quite so much transportation or to minimize the transportation, then people will eat what grows and can be raised in their areas. Also doesn't seem very complicated to me.
A change in alimentary habits has also deep effects in switching resources from some industries to others, and this easily creates resistance and opposition. Which is the role of consumers, governments, and corporations to reach the goal?
Well, corporations have one goal, and only one goal, and that's to sell product and sell more products as fast and as quickly and as profitably as they can. That's their job, to do that. The job of government and the job of consumers is much more focused on public health. And it seems to me that there has to be some kind of balance between consumer interest, public health interest, government interest, and corporate interest, and that means regulation. I think we need far more regulation in the food area, and that if we had more regulation, we would have much healthier diets for everybody.
Mrs. Nestle, thank you for participating in this conversation.